Good morning students, in this session we will study the different failures of the turnbuckle. First we will study the failure of threaded rod in tension. This is the threaded rod. This is the threaded rod. This is threaded rod in tension. This shows the failure of threaded rod in tension. So resisting area is pi by 4. This is the DC, pi by 4 DC square. So strength equation will be equal to W is equal to W is the load applied. And RA is resisting area in tension multiplied by permissible stresses in tension. So putting the value of resisting area pi by 4 DC square multiplied by sigma t. This is the first strength equation of the turnbuckle. Now second, we will consider the failure of threads in shear at their roots. Suppose this is the core diameter on which threads are cut, and this type of failure, the link comes out in the form of threads, or threads are coming in the form of rings. So this total area is given by the pi DC, where DC is the core diameter and L is the link. Pi DC L is the shear area, and the strength equation is given by W is equal to resisting area into tau, because failure is in shear. So this is equal to pi DC L, that is the shear area, into tau. This is the second strength equation. Now third failure is the failure of threads in crushing at flanks of the threads. Here threads are there on the rod, and if they are subjected for crushing, and the failure of crushing thread is shown like this. It will crush at the flanks. So this type of failure is known as crushing failure. In this we see, if single thread is subjected for crushing, then the crushing area will be, for single thread, this is the crushing area, where this is the outer diameter and this is the core diameter. So the total area for single thread will be pi by 4 d o square minus d c square. This is for single thread, and if number of threads are L, and L is the length per unit inch, or per unit length is there, then the crushing area is here given by pi by 4 dO square minus dC square multiplied by L multiplied by L, where L is the number of thread per unit length. So this is the crushing area. And the strength equation in crushing is given by load is equal to crushing area multiplied by crushing stress, permissible crushing stress. So putting the value of crushing area in this, we have the strength equation in crushing. W is equal to pi by 4 in the bracket dO square minus dC square, bracket is complete, multiplied by L, where N is the number of thread per unit length, multiplied by L. This is the crushing area multiplied by permissible crushing stress. So this is the next strength equation, third strength equation. Next we will consider the tensile failure of coupler nut. This is the coupler nut. We have taken this coupler nut, and this is the tensile failure. If we will see the resisting area, this is the resisting area, pi by 4 d o square minus d o square. The resisting area is pi by 4 in the bracket capital D square minus small d o square, where small d o is the outer diameter of the fringe and capital D is the outer diameter of the coupler nut. So this is the resisting area. Now the strength equation in tension is given by W is equal to resisting area multiplied by sigma T. That is, putting the value of resisting area, that is pi by 4 in the bracket capital D square minus small d o square, bracket is complete, multiplied by sigma T. This is the strength equation in tension. This is number 4. In this way we have obtained fourth strength equation. Next we consider the tensile failure of coupler. This is complete coupler that fails along this section. This is the failure of coupler in tension. Tensile force is applied here. The resisting area is given by this circle, and where capital D2 is the outer diameter of coupler and D1, capital D1 is the inner diameter of coupler, and the resisting area is given by pi by 4 in the bracket capital D2 square minus capital D1 square. This is the resisting area in tension of the coupler. Now strength equation is given by the W is equal to resisting area into sigma T, that is equal to pi by 4 in the bracket capital D2 square minus D1 square, bracket is complete, multiplied by sigma T. In this way we have obtained the fifth strength equation.